Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy. Welcome back to another episode of Unfiltered Talks. Today, we're going to be kind of talking about something that I think is a little weird. But that being said, recently, there have been a couple of movies that have came out that are kind of like in between genres. And it's kind of like using two different genres together that wouldn't necessarily typically be together. And I found them both very fun. So one of the movies I'm talking about is obviously Damsel from Netflix. This was the big one with Millie Bobby Brown, where it started off as a fun little fairy tale movie. It seemed like she was going to be going into this fun little princess world where she was going to be a princess, and she just found her knight in shining armor and everything was going to be great. And then it very quickly got turned on its head and turned into a survivor thriller. And I thought that was cool. And I really liked the fact that it kind of like had one genre for a little bit, and then it kind of like completely did a 360. That's wrong. It did a complete 180, and it completely changed genres, and I thought that was cool, and I really liked that. And then last week, we got a fun little musical rom-com, which I feel like that probably happens more often. Like, there are probably other musical rom-coms out there, but I just really like this little notion of there being two different genres and them kind of coming together in this beautiful way. So today I'm going to be pitching kind of genres that I would like to see kind of interconnect with each other. And then at the end, I have one that is a pitch for a full-on like movie that would be two separate genres. And it's a movie pitch that I've been working on for a while. It's a script that I write in my free time, and I just wanted to talk about it. So that being said, let's go ahead and dive into this. Alrighty, so for starters, I'm going to be starting off with something that I am very familiar with. Obviously, on the wall behind me, I have a bunch of Marvel paraphernalia. I'm a big fan of superhero movies. I think that they're really cool. Even some of the ones that are coming out nowadays that a lot of you guys are like, oh my god, they're trash, they're incredibly mid, I still at least have a good time with them. So my first couple of ones that I have are going to be specific types of things that I think they should start doing with superhero movies that could spice them up a little bit. The first one, this is one that is actually happening, and I am really excited about it, but a superhero musical would be incredibly cool. And something that I particularly like about the idea of a superhero musical is the fact that these characters are already dressing up in over-the-top costumes, and it's already a very ridiculous movie. So the idea of just throwing in like a supervillain that loves singing instead of monologuing, it works. I feel like it's really cool for the general idea of the plot. And then on top of that, if you go back to like some old CW TV shows, The Flash and Supergirl had a fun little episode where they crossed over with each other, and they had a villain called the Music Meister that just basically trapped them in a fun little musical, and it was a musical episode of a superhero TV show, and it was just incredibly fun watching these people who usually would have to punch their way out of their problems have to just follow the script and kind of sing little songs and be, you know, little musical theater kids. And I feel like there's something whimsical and fun about that, and I think that musicals overall just bring a good vibe to any form of movie or TV show. And on top of that, I feel like movies like Guardians of the Galaxy, which have music as such an important part of their iconography, and like you can't think of the Guardians of the Galaxy trilogy without thinking of some of the great songs that were working with them. And I just think it'd be really interesting to try to make like a character who is already over the top and loves to like put on a show, and just make them more of a show person and literally start like singing and dancing. I don't know. I feel like it'd be a funny thing. And the one pitch that I've heard for this before was somebody wanted Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse to be a musical where they go into, you know, Spider-Punk's universe, and it finds out that everybody there just constantly is singing and doing music stuff. And what's it called? Miles had to like step out of his, you know, comfort zone and sing, and like they'll do songs together. And then the main villain for that was going to be Dr. Octopus, and it's going to be a Doc Ock variant played by Jack Black. And I still to this day would love to see that. I doubt it will ever come to fruition, obviously, because this is just a random person on the internet who had this idea, but still to this day, I love it. I think it's great, and I would love to see a musical superhero movie. Alrighty, now kind of sticking with the musical theme here a little bit, I also think it'd be really cool to see some kind of like musical noir. If you've ever been to like a dinner party show where they kind of have like a fun little, what's it called? Like murder mystery type thing going on, and they'll be singing songs, and it's fun little like, it's a fun experience if you've ever experienced what I'm talking about. If you don't and you have no idea what I'm talking about, sometimes you'll go to a place that has a dinner and a show, and they'll like put on a show, but then they make it more interactive by having like somebody gets murdered and you guys have to figure out who murdered them and stuff like that. So based off of that thought, I think that it would be really cool if we had like musical noirs. Like imagine the Agatha Christie movies that have been coming out, like A Death on the Nile, maybe think of like Glass Onion, stuff like that. But with, instead of it being like Benoit Blanc who's taking things incredibly serious, it's just like a musical. And I think that one way we could totally do something like this is having it be something like there's a musical family and they all like make music together. Some of them are like, you know, in a boy band, whatever. Some of them actually are into like classical music and stuff like that. And one of them dies. And instead of them like, you know, doing the regular interview process where they're trying to, you know, find the clues and stuff like that, they're all like making songs about how they're, you know, feeling now that their person has passed away. And one of them uses lyrics that make it seem like they're more sad that they lost their, you know, source of income as opposed to losing their grandfather or something like that. And that's how they figure out who the murderer is. I don't know. It's kind of a really dumb concept, but I think it would be really funny and I would really enjoy it. And once again, this is one that like I know a lot of people are not that into musicals, but I feel like if you can pull it off and you can make it in a way that feels natural and organic like that, it would be really interesting. So overall, my concept for this is there's a bunch of different people who are making music and they have to make a song about, you know, this person who passed away. And you realize that some of them didn't actually care about the person who passed away. And it's a little suspicious how much they did not care. I don't know. I don't think that one makes sense as much, but it was just an idea that I had. So I had to share it. Okay, but I think that that's the last one that I have that's a musical. But to go back to superhero stuff for a second, I really, really want a movie that fully dives into the concept of a superhero and a supervillain falling in love with each other. I know that there are probably books that do it, and I'm sure that there's probably even like Marvel or DC comic books that do it. But I just love the overall concept of a superhero who kind of has a soft spot for a specific villain. And sometimes, you know, they have this little fling and they have this weird romance. And then at the end of the movie, they just kind of let the villain go away. But I would love to see one where the superhero actually kind of like helps the villain kind of, you know, go to therapy and do things to like, you know, better themselves. And obviously, the city is going to be after the supervillain because they've done so many bad things and they have to pay for their crime. But then you can watch, you know, the superhero kind of like, you know, try to defend them and try to be like, no, they're changing. They're changing their ways. They're being a better person. And then obviously people are going to start being outraged at the superhero because they're all of a sudden defending this villain. And then they have to run away together. And it's a beautiful love movie. It's like Bonnie and Clyde, except for one of them, Clyde wasn't as bad, or Bonnie wasn't as bad. And I don't know. I just think that one could be fun. And I know that some people are going to be like, that's kind of like Megamind. Every movie is kind of like Megamind. That movie is cinematic excellence, okay? And now while I'm still on the topic of romance, this one I've kind of, they kind of had one just like it recently, so it's not that out there, but kind of a slasher horror movie that turns into a rom-com. I really love the movie Lisa Frankenstein that came out a couple of months ago. I think it was in February. And I've preached to a lot of people that I think it's going to be a movie I'm going to have to watch every single Halloween. And I just like the fact that it has so much like horror elements to it. But at the end of the day, it is just a fun little rom-com. And I feel like I could see something like that working out with a Scream type movie where there's a person going around killing everybody. And then whenever, you know, they're doing this, they find out that one girl basically confesses. She's just like, in case I don't live forever, somebody needs to tell Brian that I really have a massive crush on him. And Brian, surprise, surprise, is actually the murderer. He kind of gives up his murder spree so that he can start dating this girl. And then the girl finds out that he was the murderer. And then he's conflicted with whether or not he's going to continue his murder spree and kill her, or if he's going to turn himself in because he wants to be a better person for her. But plot twist, she's actually kind of into it and she joins him. And now they both go on a murder spree together. I don't know. Could be fun. Could be really stupid. Once again, this is not going to be everybody's cup of tea, but I love rom-coms and I'm starting to get into slasher horror films. And if they made a movie that was similar to this, it would be really interesting. My only problem is I think a lot of people wouldn't like this movie because a lot of times slasher horror films need to be taken a little more serious because death is, you know, obviously a very important thing. You can't joke around with death. But at the same time, if it's obvious that they're going for a rom-com and they're going more for a comedy side of things, I think people would understand. I don't know. That was just a concept that I had. But yeah, those are all of my little just like, here's a genre and here's, you know, another genre. Here's what I want to see them, you know, go together. And then me kind of trying to like connect a little bit of story beats so you can kind of get what I'm saying. But now I have the movie that I'm kind of working on a script for that I've been working on for a really long time that kind of combines two genres that I think would be really interesting. So yeah, let's dive into this. Alrighty, so this next one, it is going to be another superhero related thing. Once again, I am a big fan of superhero stuff. It's what got me into movies in the first place. And this concept that I have is one that I've kind of been thinking about for a really long time. I feel like the best way to kind of think of it is I feel like it kind of feels like Percy Jackson-esque in the fact that my concept here, the name of it, which is just a working title, is What Lies Beyond. And the movie is going to start off as like a Sky High type movie. It's going to start off with young superheroes in a world where superheroes are kind of normal and they have like special schools where the superheroes can go and they can train and they can learn more about their powers. And it's going to be following a group of kids who all came from like this big super family, like think maybe like the Justice League or the Avengers, right? This big super team. And they all came from those families and they're all, you know, expected to be these cool like scholars who are really powerful and they really have, you know, these cool abilities, right? And so a lot of them are going to this school to practice their skills, work on their superpowers a little bit. And some of them are kind of like late bloomers, right? Like they are starting to get their powers now, but like they don't know how to like use them. They don't know what exactly triggers them or how they work. And for the most part, a lot of the kids will be starting to get the hang of it, right? But we're going to be focusing on this kid. I don't remember what his name is right now, but we're going to give him a placeholder name of like Jeffrey or something. And we're focusing on Jeffrey here. And his parents are basically like Superman and Wonder Woman. Like they are like the heroes of heroes. They are insanely cool. Everybody thinks that this kid's going to be the most powerful person ever. And he's dealing with the stress of that. And he's about 15 years old. And he still to this day does not know what his power is. He's trying to figure it out. He's throwing everything at the wall to see what sticks, and nothing is. And he's been going to the school for now about 2 years. And while everybody else is learning a lot about their powers, about how to be a superhero and stuff like this, he's just kind of having to learn all the prerequisites over and over again because he doesn't have his powers yet. They haven't sprouted. And as of right now, they're not entirely sure if they're going to. And people are trying to, you know, like scare him and do stuff to try to like make his powers come out in case they're just like lying dormant or something. And what's going to happen is one day he's going to figure out that his powers are to freeze time, and he's going to accidentally freeze time in the middle of class. And he's going to notice the entire world around him is kind of like staying still. Nobody's moving, nobody's doing anything. And it's going to start off as this fun little thing. He's going to be like, oh my god, I finally found my powers. He's so excited. He's kind of dancing around. He's messing around with people while the time's frozen. And then after 5 or 10 minutes go by and he's just goofing around being a normal teenager about this, he realizes he doesn't know how he stopped time. And he doesn't know how to unstop time. And he's basically going to go around trying to figure out how to undo it. And this, I think, would work a little bit better as, like, a limited series and be, like, a one season, 13 episodes type thing instead of, like, a full-on movie. But the concept would be it's a superhero little movie that starts off very fun and lighthearted like a lot of superhero movies are nowadays. And it would kind of turn into, like, a psychological thriller where this guy has frozen time and he doesn't know how to undo it. And he now has to deal with, like, the isolationism that he feels. And something that'll happen because he froze time is certain monsters and creatures that have been defended from entering Earth through different dimensions are now able to come through because the heroes who've been defending them are currently frozen in time. And now it's going to be this hero basically saving the entire world by himself because he's the only person who isn't frozen in time. And he's going to go through all these hardships. He's going to go through all these battles, all these fights. In the script, I do have another character who is also awake during this time, but his power isn't that he can, the other person's power isn't that they can freeze time, it's that they're unaffected by other people's powers. So he's basically just like an immune dude, right? And other than that power, he's basically just a guy. And they're gonna go together and try to defeat all of these monsters and stuff like that. And it'd be a really long show with these two kind of doing everything that they can to try to unfreeze time. And in my original pitch, they would basically like grow old together, and then at the end of his lifetime, once he dies, time will just continue and everyone's gonna be like, oh my god, where did Jeffrey go? But I'm still working on it, right? I'm still workshopping it. But that's the general concept. And I really just like the concept of a superhero show with teenagers that have them kind of learning about their powers, and since they're kids, not really understanding how they work. Because if everybody has different powers, no one knows what triggers certain people's powers. No one can really explain to them how their powers work. They just have to figure it out on their own. And I feel like it could be an interesting show like that. But yeah, that's my concept for that one. And those were my concepts for different genres I would like to see mixed together. And I am going to leave this video here. Thank you guys so much for coming by and checking it out. I love and appreciate you guys so much for watching. If you liked it, feel free to like and subscribe. And I will hopefully see you guys in the next one. Peace out. Bow. Bow. Bow.
Back at it again, but that's irrelevant. Flow so smooth, they calling me Mr. Elegant. Like an elephant, I got a long nose. Like a president, I've got a few hoes. Swift with a stutter, I'm smooth like butter. Don't see it coming when I slip undercover. Like a big dog, but I don't bite. I'm still a big broad, I'd win that fight. Come at you and I knock out your lights.